Hello, countable beings. I am Infinity, but I wear a pineapple costume because I look strange without it. Well, but what does it mean? I mean, Infinity. It's never ending, right? Like Kermit edits. Maybe. Anyway, let's try to understand what Infinity is. In the 1920s, David Hilbert introduced a new experiment named Hilbert's Paradox of the Grand Hotel. And guess what? We are rich in this experiment. I guess it would be fun to tell this by making a story. Long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, you had a hotel with an infinite number of rooms, and you were the manager of your hotel. Yes, you were a banana. You worked so hard for a long time and found infinite people for your hotel. Infinite room and infinite guests. So it means the hotel was full, right? When you were counting your infinite money, a lion-faced man came to the hotel and said, "Your room or your money?" You said, "No problem, I can arrange you a room." Because you had an infinite number of rooms, there had to be a room for this man. Actually, yes, there was a room for this man. You went to the guest in the first room and said, "Can you go to room number 2? And she did what you said. You told the guest in the second room to go to the third room. You went to all the rooms and told the guest to go to the next room. 12,359 guests moved to room number 12,360 and etc. You have completely walked an endless hotel instead of using the microphone and telling everyone to go to the next room. What a shame. You had huge leg muscles, but all guests had a new room and you had an extra empty room. It was the first room. Perfect. You gave the first room's key to that weird man and took a breath. But then, four men in strange clothes came to the lobby and said, "Give us 4 room." You opened the microphone because you didn't want to walk all over the hotel again and said, "Can everybody go to the next 4th room, please?" The lion-faced man in the first room moved to 5th room. If you could understand what you mean, others did too. Everybody moved to their next 4th room. There was infinite room, so it means everybody could find a new room for themselves. And you had an extra 4 empty rooms. You gave 4 men their room's case and relaxed. A man came near you. He was our solar system taxi driver, Lion, and he said, "I have an infinite guest in my car. Can you arrange them rooms?" You didn't know what to do because you realized you couldn't tell guests to go to the next room. They had to go to the next room forever, and it was impossible. You found another way. You assigned all the guests to the room number 2 times of their current room numbers. For example, the lion-faced man moved to the 10th room from the 5th room. The guest in the 100th room moved to the 200th room. So you assigned all guests to even-numbered rooms. All the odd-numbered rooms were empty and you managed to find rooms for all the infinite number of guests. Maybe you were not aware of it, but you have managed to find rooms for infinite plus 5 people in a hotel with infinite rooms with infinite number of guests. Gauss, Euler, and Harasmi were probably proud of you. Oh hey, what was that? There were endless limousines out there, and endless guests inside each limousine. It seemed a little bit impossible. Infinite times infinite, how can it be possible? You read all math books, and then you found the magical answer. How many times do I have to say that there are infinitely many prime numbers? From Euclid, you did a quick calculation. You had infinite prime numbers, and none of them are coefficients of each other. If you got an infinite sequence with each prime number, you had infinite rooms for infinite times, and it was what you needed. You just used the power of prime numbers. You assigned all current numbers to the first prime number, 2 raised to the power of their current room number. The guest in the 5th room moved to room number 2 to the 5, so room number 32. You assigned all guests in the hotel their new rooms and there were so many empty rooms. You went to the first limousine and said, "Please, can everybody go to the 3 raised to the power of their seat number?" Amazingly, they all understood what you mean and they perfectly did it. For example, the guest in the 4th seat went to room number 3 to the 4, so room number 81. You did it for all limousines, powers of 5, powers of 7, powers of 11, and so on. and none of them mixed with each other because they occupied the powers of prime numbers. Surprisingly, there were still empty rooms. The sixth room was empty because it wasn't a power of any prime number. Interesting, right? You had a full hotel with infinite people. One lion-faced man, plus four men in strange clothes, plus infinite people, plus infinite time infinite people came to the hotel, and then you still had empty rooms. Did you understand how complex infinity is? Guess what? It was just the lowest level of infinity, the countable infinity of natural numbers. I know, this level of infinity is already confusing. So look at the Zeno paradox. Just imagine that you shoot an arrow towards a tree. It moves half the distance ahead each time. For example, if there are 10 meters between the tree and arrow, it will go 5 meters first, then go 2.5 meters, and so on. Can the arrow reach the tree? The answer is yes. But it's another video's topic. Take care of yourself. You learned that mathematics still makes problems even if you make infinite money. Sorry, but it's true. Close the computer and relax. These days are hard for you. Remember, you are infinitely precious. Goodbye, countable beings. Did you stop recording? Oh, when do you think they will notice that we made it up because we couldn't find the original sentence of Euclid? Never mind, who cares?